Hello and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you what I found at the thrift store this week. If you like this kind of content, as well as decor and DIY videos, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel. And of course, you can always find me on Instagram at Nicole North Garden. Here we go. Hello everyone, I am here. I'm sorry this is coming to you a little bit late today. It has been a very, very busy weekend. If you follow me on Instagram, you have seen that we've done a lot of entertaining this week. I've posted some pictures of our tablescapes from Thanksgiving, as well as a brunch that we hosted this morning. So we've been up to a lot, decorating for the holidays, going out, chopping down a tree. I have a video that I'll put up about that sometime later in the week. But it's been busy. And so I did get to one thrift store this week. So I'm going to show you what I got there. And then I'm also going to show you some heirloom ornaments that my mother-in-law gave to us. They are from my husband's childhood. They're actually from my mother-in-law's mother. So I'm going to show you those, and then I'll show you my baby ball as well, because I thought those might be things that you'd be interested to see, since I know you guys all like vintage Christmas. So let's go ahead and get into my thrift haul first. So the first thing I found, you know, I love these crocheted pot holders, and this one was 25 cents. And the way that I use these is basically I hang them on the wall in my kitchen, or, you know, around the house. I might also use them on a shelf under a display, almost like a doily. I like that they come in, you know, lots of different colors. And when there's no, sometimes there's like three-dimensional stitching on them, which is very cool. But when there's not, they're much easier to use as like a doily. So that's what I will use that for. And I liked this one because it was in Christmassy colors. So 25 cents on that. Okay, and then I found two little wooden, I guess they're kind of like, well, this is definitely a wooden ornament. They had a basket of ornaments. It was just 25 cents a piece, and I thought he was really cute. And I like that the moon was pink. And just cute. It's not marked. But I will put that with my other vintage wooden ornaments. I got this little guy for crafting. He was also 25 cents. And I thought he'll be cute in a display or an assemblage. I think his face is really cute. And it looks hand-painted, so. And someone added snow to his hat, so this is probably someone's DIY. And I'm going to incorporate it into my own DIY. So that was 25 cents. Okay, then I found a little bag, and it was $2 of the, you know, molded candles that I really love. It came with these two. They're fine. I'm going to incorporate them into my collection. So these two little, I guess they're choir ladies. They have, it looks like they're holding choir music. So those were really cute. They're not painted on the back, which is a little funny and different from the other ones that I have. But what I really got it for were these two. Oh my goodness. I love these. I would have paid $2 for these alone. So I got this one. And these just look older to me. Again, not painted on the back. And this one's a little chipped, but that doesn't matter to me. You can see, you can't tell that from the front. And you know I love Santas. And then I got him. Oh my goodness, he's so cute. Look at him. I just love deer. And this is so cute. This one is painted on the back. And so these are going into my vintage 7-Up crate that I have hanging on my wall. I think I've shown it to you before. I put little salt shakers in it. I had my turkeys on it at Thanksgiving time, and now I'm using it for my molded candles. So that's where those will go. Okay, then I found this. I paid $1 for it. Maybe one of you knows. I don't know anything about it. I just thought it was really pretty because it has this strawberry on it. And it's like, it's not milk glass per se. It looks like clear glass, but almost that's like frosted or something. I don't know. And I thought it was really, really pretty and looked well done. And this is like, I don't know if you can tell, but this is like a gold color here. And then the red and the green. So I thought that was really pretty. And, you know, it's a creamer, I suppose, but I will use it in my strawberry collection. And actually, as I'm putting it down, it kind of looks nice with this, if you could picture what that would look like on a shelf. So, okay, and then the last thing I found, it was a small haul because I did not have a lot of time to do thrifting this week. I got this bowl, and this is super useful. And you know, I've started for myself an ironstone collection, and I have a creamer and sugar bowl that are very similar to this pattern. They might even be the same mark. Federalist Ironstone, made in Japan, dishwasher safe and oven proof. I think that is the same mark. I would have to look. And we actually used the creamer for gravy on Thanksgiving. So that was a great use. And Ironstone is safe to use for eating. I have read all about it. So this was only $1 and I thought that was really nice. I didn't use it on Thanksgiving and I had it already. And I think I had just kind of set stuff aside because I knew I wanted to film a haul and then I forgot about it. So I totally could have washed it up and taken the sticker off and still shown it to you guys, but gotten a use in at Thanksgiving and I just forgot. So, but it's a nice size and it's a nice size for like mashed potatoes. You know, if you don't want a huge bowl on your table or a vegetable, you know, if you have broccoli or corn or whatever, it's a nice size bowl. So that was $1. Okay. That is it for my thrift haul. Now I'm going to go ahead and show you the vintage ornaments that my mother-in-law sent to us. So I'm going to repair the box and I'm probably going to display the boxes because you know me, I love old boxes. So they just say tree ornaments. And again, I don't know if these are like the original boxes or not, but and they have great graphics on them. See the Santa Christmas tree ornaments. I love that. So let's take some of these out and take a closer look. And I have a vintage ornaments tree in my bedroom. So that's where all of these are going to hang. So, and I can't read the tops of them. They are marked, but I can't read. I would have to get a magnifier out, but they're really pretty and they're very large. Like, I don't know if you can tell comparing them to my hand, they're actually quite big. That one, this one's really pretty. This one has some paint loss, but that does not matter to me. And oh, this one's really pretty. I love this one actually. Look at the design here. And some of them even have the old hooks, which I think are really cool. And my Christmas tree downstairs is flocked. And so it really makes these old ornaments pop. I have some of the shiny brights that I've found and shown to you already. They're already down there. And they just, they look really great on the flocked tree. This one. And this one. So that's the one box. And oops, second box, which looks the same. Oopsie. Probably in better, in worse shape, I mean. So I'm gonna do some repairs on that. This has some that aren't vintage. These are Disney. These just need to go on our Disney tree. We call her Disney Diana, so. She also gave us some Disney ones, but the ones that are old are these. So there's this one. Really pretty. Again, this is gonna look great against the white of the flocked tree, and I have white lights on it. I will show that to you all. And this one's missing its little topper. It's another one, it's a duplicate. So I'll have to find a way to hang it, even though it's missing that topper. And then, oh, that's it for those. And then one other ornament I wanted to show you is this. This is my baby ornament. And I guess my love for all little girls in bonnets and Holly Hobby looking children started early because this is my baby ball. So I think that's neat. And it is missing its topper. If any of you has creative ideas of what to do when you're missing a topper, other than finding a topper, which I guess is what I'll probably try to do. But if you have any other ideas, let me know, because I do have some balls that are missing their toppers. So I'm going to put that in with those other ones, and then it stays with the vintage ornaments. So, okay, and that's all that I have for you today. I hope you've enjoyed seeing my thrift haul from the week, and also these heirloom ornaments that were sent to me by my mother-in-law and my baby ball. If you like this kind of content, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel. And of course, you can always find me and my adventures on Instagram. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.